Hi guys, a very good morning. How are you all doing? I hope you had a good weekend ahead and you all enjoyed, had fun, and everything is fine. You are healthy, safe, sound, staying at home, and enjoying. So it's great to see you back again. And so today's Tuesday, and we are going to start with the third chapter, the Sultanate period. Now see, excuse me, I want to tell you one thing is that the Sultanate period, or rather the Sultanate Delhi period, is a very important chapter. I don't want you to hurry into it because I have got lot of explanations for you, for it to get into your head. What you will learn now will take you through till class 10. Or till your lifetime, if you just listen to me, and I'll try to make it interesting so that you don't get bored. Actually, it is sometimes people do get bored and they think that history, what sir is saying, blah blah blah, I'm not understanding anything, so it's not making sense. But yes, it does make sense. We have to know some things about the past. I know it gets boring, but I'll try to make it interesting for you. I'll do it in parts. So we'll start with Sultanate period. I guess it's going to take 2-3 classes, means Tuesday, Thursday, and again Tuesday, and on the next Thursday I might give you the question answers, or by that time if school opens, good, I'll be doing it with you in the school only itself. Okay, so let's start rocking. I hope you guys have had breakfast fit and fine, strong. Hi Tiger, hi Chita, hi Soumya, hi Pallavi, hi Sonali, hi, Alam, Ayush, Divyanshu, hi Sachin, hi Shivam, 21, and again, few names I don't remember. Yes, Anushka, then I have Nikki, and forget it. So I'll remember those names again. I'm very bad at names. I just don't remember names. I'm very bad at it. Okay, fine. So let's start. We are going to talk about the Sultanate period. Okay, so what is all about this Sultanate period? See, Sultanate, the Delhi Sultanate, or the Sultanate of Delhi, is actually not to be confused with the spelling Deli. Okay, the Sultanate of Delhi, we should not, because it was called Delhi at some point of time. Okay, so we have to make sure that Sultanate of Delhi was actually a Malay state in Sumatra in 1630. We can't call it Delhi. That was Delhi, and this is Delhi, Delhi. Okay, so Sultanate Delhi is something different. It's a Malay state. When you see the spelling Deli, never go ahead and talk something about Delhi or any of the sultans. That the Sultanate of Delhi was the Sultanate of Siak, that's in Sumatra, founded in 1630. So forget about that. So when you see the spelling Delhi, then only you start talking about Delhi, our India. Okay, so that's the basic confusion which we generally have. I wanted to share it with you. So Delhi Sultanate is actually basically from 12006 to 1526. So that's round about 320 years. Okay, so in the Indian subcontinent, and you know what's all this Indian subcontinent about. So the Indian subcontinent is the southern region and the peninsula of Asia, as you know. So it's guarded by water from three sides, mostly situated on the Indian plate and projecting southwards into the Indian Ocean from the Himalayas. Geologically, the Indian subcontinent is related to the landmass that rifted from Gondwana and merged with the other places. Clear? Okay, fine. So Delhi Sultanate was an Islamic empire based in Delhi that stretched over parts of the Indian subcontinent for 320 years, 1206 to 1526. five dynasties were there that ruled over the Delhi Sultanate sequentially. Okay, the Slave Dynasty, the Khalji Dynasty, okay, and the Tughlaq Dynasty, the Sayyid Dynasty, and the Lodi Dynasty. Okay, the Slave Dynasty can be called the Mamluk Dynasty also. Okay, before the Khilji Dynasty, it can be also called the Mamluk Dynasty or the Slave Dynasty. Okay, clear. So there are five dynasties. You have read the Mamluk Dynasty was directed into the northern India by Qutbuddin Aibak, a Turkic Mamluk general from Central Asia. Just above Himalaya part, from Central Asia he had come in. The Mamluk Dynasty ruled from 1206 to 1290. It was the first of five unrelated dynasties to rule as Delhi Sultanate till 1526. Aibak's tenure as a Ghurid. Okay, so Mamluk Dynasty, we can call it as the Slave Dynasty as well, which was dealt by Qutbuddin Aibak, 1206 to 1290. So what the basic idea we get, there are five dynasties. Out of the first five dynasties, we get the first one, that is 1206 to 1290, the Mamluk Dynasty or the Slave Dynasty, which was started by Qutbuddin Aibak. Clear. Then we have the second dynasty is called the Khilji Dynasty. That is again 1290 to 1320. Clear. So I'll just give a brief thing. Khilji or Khilji Dynasty was a Muslim dynasty which ruled parts of Indian of the Indian subcontinent between 1290 to 1320. It was founded by Jalaluddin Firoz Khilji and became the second dynasty to rule the Delhi Sultanate of India. The dynasty is known for their faithfulness and ferocity. I'll come to that later. I'll explain you more about these dynasties so that it gets into your head and you'll be able to solve it properly as per your explanation. If anyone asks you, so that you know what is this all about. Correct. So we have the Mamluk Dynasty done, or the Slave Dynasty. Then we have the Khilji Dynasty, 1290 to 1320, and the Slave Dynasty is from 1206 to 1210. Actually, it shows Qutbuddin Aibak, Qutbuddin Aibak's, wait, there's some problem here. 1320, 1290 and 1320. Yes, exactly about that only, it's right. But here in your book, it says they have just given it in a total, where it expands actually, no issues. But it is Qutbuddin Aibak says it's from 1206 to 1210. Okay, 1206 to 1210, but actually it is till 1290. All the breakups are there of Shamsuddin Iltutmish, Ruknuddin Firoza, Razia Sultan. So these were the people who were there ruling during that time. But the main Slave Dynasty timing is from 1206 to 1290. Khilji Dynasty is from 1290 to 1320. Now between that, who were those people there, we are going to discuss about that. Clear. Now Qutbuddin Aibak, we'll start with Qutbuddin Aibak. Actually, what was Qutbuddin Aibak all about, we'll come to know, and I'll just explain it to you, and I hope I can make some notes for you and give it to you so that it will be easy for you to learn as well. Okay, so don't worry about that. You must have received the last week's homework and all. It's been uploaded. You must have received it. You must have got it on Friday, I guess, most probably. You must have. It was loaded on Thursday night, and you must have received it on Friday. So not a problem. So you have been satisfied. Those who are not satisfied, please jot me down a message, okay? I'll go ahead and take care of it. So let's get to Qutbuddin Aibak. एंड कुतुबुद्दीन ऐबक वॉज एक्चुअली अ फॉर्मर तर्किक मामलुक. वॉट वॉज द तर्किक मामलुक? मामलुक इज अ एक्चुअली अ टर्म कॉमनली रिफरिंग टू इधर नॉन मुस्लिम स्लेव सोल्जर्स और फ्रीड स्लेव्स और मुस्लिम कन्वर्ट्स आर साइन टू मिलिट्री एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ड्यूटी एंड मुस्लिम रूलर्स ऑफ स्लेव ओरिजिन. What did I say? The Turkic Mamluk, Kutubuddin Aybak, a former Turk. Either he was, either it is referred to a non-Muslim slave soldier, or he was a freed slave. He was under slavery. He was freed, or a Muslim convert. He was converted into Muslim, assigned to military and administrative duties, and Muslim rulers of slave origin. Or they can be that. So either one of them, they are that. Kutubuddin Aybak was a former Turkic Mamluk, slave of Muhammad Ghori. Now we have read about Mujahideen Muhammad Ghori, born Shihab ad-Din, also known as Muhammad of Ghor, was the Sultan of Ghurid Empire, along with brother Ghiyath-ud-Din Muhammad, 1173 to 1202. And as the sole ruler from 1202 to 1206, he is credited with laying foundation of Muslim rule. Got it? If you want explanation about that, I can go into more. As much as you ask me about history, I'll go into it more and more and more and more and more, so that you can understand as much as you want. It becomes interesting. You have to read it like a story. So, okay. Now, Kutubuddin Aybak was a slave, a Turkic Mamluk slave of Muhammad Ghori. Now Kutubuddin Aybak was a general of Ghurid King Muzaffaruddin Muhammad Ghori, as I said. He was in charge of Ghurid territories in northern India. And after Muhammad Ghori's death, he became the ruler of an independent kingdom that evolved into the Delhi Sultanate, ruled by the slave dynasty or the Mamluk dynasty. Clear? He was a staff of Muhammad Ghori, so he was a very faithful staff of him. He was always his slave. Yes, Guruji, yes, boss, yes, boss, yes, boss. But when the boss died, he took over that and he became the Sultanate kingdom, which evolved in Delhi, was under Kutubuddin Aybak. Understood? Clear. And his Mamluk dynasty or the slave dynasty conquered large areas of northern India. Afterwards, the victory of the Khilji dynasty expanded in the south. The Sultanate reached its peak of its geographical reach during the Tughlaq dynasty. Now, when did the Tughlaq dynasty come? Tughlaq dynasty came after the Khilji dynasty. So, what was I saying? The Kutubuddin Aybak, a former Turkic Mamluk slave of Muhammad Ghori, was the founder of Delhi Sultanate, and his Mamluk dynasty conquered large areas of northern India. Afterwards, the victories of the Khilji dynasty expanded in the south. The Sultanate reached its peak geographical, means quite a lot of geographical area of India that took by during the Tughlaq dynasty, occupying the most of the Indian subcontinent. This was followed by the decline due to Hindu reconquests. States such as the Vijayanagar Empire and Mewar asserting independence, and new Muslim sultanates such as the Bengal Sultanate breaking off in 1526, the Sultanate was conquered and succeeded by the Mughal Empire. Okay. Understood? This is all I told you. So this is just an explanation of the first part. Actually, the part I'm going to explain, then we'll go in different parts. I'll make it in different parts for you to understand. I'm coming back in the next video and I'll start again and explain it to you. Okay.